Amen. I just want to share this quickly with you. God laid upon my heart, and I'm speaking to every leader right now, every man, woman of God going through some battle, no matter what office you are in. I'm going to speak to you now. This is what God put upon my heart. How far will you go in trusting Him? How far will you go in believing God? Amen. You know, I begin to think about Abraham. Now, you need to understand that the enemy, amen, could have used the situation to destroy the marriage of Abraham. Amen. He could have discredited Abraham in the community, because Abraham had to do something. Hallelujah. He had to obey God at the expense of so much. Abraham was about to lose everything. Now, one minute God said, I'm going to give you a son from the woman Sarah, his wife. She gave birth. Before that, hallelujah, he had no sons besides Ishmael. And God told him, gave him a promise. He says, I'm going to fulfill my covenant through Isaac. And he said, count the stars. And then he said, count the sand. He said, that's how many your children will be. And then the moment the prophetic word comes to pass, this is what happens. The Bible says, God came after a few years, and he said, give me your son, your only son. And the Bible said he was at that level tested. The reason why Abraham was called the father of faith, because his faith was stretched. Amen. Because number one, God said he's going to give him a son. So he had to trust God for the miracle. But now he had to trust God that God understands, and God, hallelujah, is going to take away what he promised. He's going to take away the son, Isaac. And the Bible goes on to say he had to put his faith in God. And he came to the place, amen, where God showed him to sacrifice his son. They went up to the mountain. As he was about to sacrifice some, God stopped him. And God says, now I know, amen, now I know that you trust me. Now I know that you have faith. There are many people, they say they have faith. There are many people, they say they believe in God. But you know what? Let me say this something. That your faith can only be tested, amen, in sacrifice. Your faith, are you a living sacrifice? Amen. Are you on the altar? Hallelujah. How far will you go in trusting God? Amen. What are you willing to give up for God? Nowadays, when God tells you to fast, you can't even give up a plate of food, but you want God to use you. Amen. There's a sacrifice. There's a price to be paid for the anointing. And there are times, hallelujah, the devil, hallelujah, wants you to be complacent. He wants you to be stagnant. He wants you to be lazy, spiritually lazy. It is those that invest deeper, amen, that God's going to remember. Amen. It's not just those that speak, hallelujah, because you see, your words mean nothing if your actions don't follow through. But I'm coming here to speak to you that sometimes, hallelujah, you need to give in your own vision. Amen, fathers, to believe in your vision. Amen. Because you see, your vision is what God put in you. Hallelujah. The vision that God put in you is like a baby, and you need to birth that thing. And there are forces against it. Amen. There are forces against it. There are people against it. It can be your family. It can be members. It can be neighbors. It can be friends. There are people against what God has put inside of you. And you're going to have to fight for it. And how far will you go in trusting God in the season? How far will you go in believing? Hallelujah. Because you see, allowing God to move upon your life, allowing God to just make decisions for you, where you just yield to His will, hallelujah, will take you to the next level. God established His covenant that day when Abraham was willing to sacrifice, hallelujah. How far will you go in trusting God? Some of you are broken right now. Some of you don't have faith right now. Some of you, you feel like, you know, I'm going to throw in the towel. The reason why you want to throw in the towel, hallelujah, because you see, you're in a test, hallelujah. You're in a test, and you need to come to the place where you allow the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, to reveal to you the process that you are in, because God is processing you, hallelujah. You see, silver, when the silver goes through the fire, the moment the man that puts the silver through the fire, the silversmith, if he looks at the silver after it came out of the fire and he doesn't see his face in it, He sends it back into the fire. And sometimes God allows you to go back into the fire because he has not seen his face in you yet. Amen. How far were you going trusting God? God told you to do something. Amen. And you are afraid. But now you need to question yourself. Hallelujah. Why are you afraid? Is it because, hallelujah, of past experiences? Is it because people don't believe in you? What's the reason? My question to you is, how far will you go in trusting God? Are you willing to take that step of faith? Amen. And walk on water while the rest will sit up in the boat.